Hey guys, Level Cap here, and today in gaming, Warzone's mid-season update has been revealed. We've got a DC fandom recap, a console port of Microsoft Flight Sim is in the works, and more. Call of Duty Modern Warfare Season 5 update made some big changes to the Warzone map, added new guns, tons of new cosmetics, and more. And there's additional content on the way. The mid-season update has been revealed. It launches tomorrow, adding a new Warzone mode, operator, gunfight tournament, new multiplayer mode, new LMG, and a double XP weekend. Starting on the 28th, a new series of trials will debut as part of the Games of Summer event. As the name implies, trials are time trials where you complete an obstacle course while trying to rack up a high score. Usually, you need trial tickets to play them, but during the Games of Summer event, all trials will be free to play. Earning gold in a trial will net you rewards that includes vehicle skins, XP tokens, vehicle horns, calling cards, and legendary weapon blueprints. As for the new LMG, it's called the Finn. It's advertised as an agile, mobile, and hostile tank of an LMG. It will likely have minimal recoil in full auto, making it ideal for those mid-range spray and pray firefights. The most popular LMG in Modern Warfare, the Bruin, recently got nerfed to dust, so the Finn might be a good replacement. It looks like the Finn might also sport a chainsaw grip. A similar gun was in Call of Duty Ghosts. That gun, which was literally called the chainsaw, was a hipfire-only weapon with an integrated laser sight. You couldn't ADS with it, but holding the ADS button would steady the gun. It was a pretty weird gun, even by Call of Duty standards. The available screenshots of the Finn shows it with the chainsaw grip and being hip-fired, so we might be getting a more unusual weapon than normal with this update. The new Warzone mode is called Kingslayer, and it's a TDM battle royale where the circle moves around the map instead of shrinking. There will be multiple teams, and the top 5 players from each team will be marked as a king on the map. Killing these kings nets you bonus points and a free killstreak. Now, we've also got some details regarding the Black Ops Cold War leak. According to a leaked pre-order description, Sergeant Woods is returning from the original game. Pre-ordering also gets you early access to the game's open beta. It'll be available on PC, Xbox One, and PlayStation 4. Cold War will follow Modern Warfare's monetization model with a battle pass, seasons, weapon packs, and more. Cold War will be officially revealed with a proper gameplay trailer on the 26th. The reveal ties in a Warzone, which will likely have an in-game event that coincides with the Cold War trailer. The DC Comics event, DC Fandom, was a massive hit with fans thanks to a series of stellar reveals. The gaming side of that are two big reveals, Gotham Knights by Warner Brothers Games in Montreal and Suicide Squad Kill the Justice League by Rocksteady. And while there wasn't any gameplay footage shown for the Suicide Squad game, both trailers were very impressive. Gotham Knights follows, well, the Knights of Gotham, aka Batgirl, Robin, Red Hood, and Nightwing after the death of Bruce Wayne. It looks like it borrows much of the gameplay elements seen in the Arkham franchise of the Batman games, but throws in co-op and obviously all new characters. However, Gotham Knights is a standalone game that doesn't tie into the Arkham franchise of games. It's an original story with a fresh take on all the characters involved. An extended gameplay walkthrough was also released that offers a ton of stuff to get hyped for, including a boss battle with Mr. Freeze on top of a skyscraper. The new Suicide Squad trailer was just a big CGI teaser showcasing the game's story and characters. That said, it still looked incredibly impressive. The characters and world design all seem really well done, and despite it not launching until 2022, it's safe to say that anticipation is certainly building for the game. Microsoft Flight Simulator launched last week, stunning the entire internet with its insane visuals and attention to detail. Currently, it's a PC-only title, but that won't be the case forever. Microsoft has previously said the game would eventually launch on both the Xbox One and the Xbox Series X, but there's no window for when that will happen. The good news is, the game's head developer gave an interview recently saying that they're working at full speed to get the console port finished. Considering just how incredible the game is, and that it already plays pretty well on a standard Xbox controller, it could be a killer next-gen launch title. In other Microsoft news, they've thrown their hat into the ring in the Epic versus Apple war over Fortnite. Microsoft voiced support for Epic with the Xbox head Phil Spencer saying on Twitter, "Ensuring that Epic has access to the latest Apple technology is the right thing for game developers and gamers." Spencer's statement follows a more official one from Microsoft that says Apple's threat to ban access to their source developer kit in the Unreal Engine will place Unreal Engine and those game creators that have built, are building, and may build games on it at a substantial disadvantage. The statement is meant to lend credence to Epic's claim that Apple holds a monopoly when it comes to their iOS App Store. It's the only way to get your software on iOS devices, and it's strictly regulated by Apple. Many of those regulations hurt developers and have prevented big names like Microsoft xCloud game streaming systems from launching on iOS. In our final story today, a new Lord of the Rings game is on its way from Daedalic Entertainment. It's called Lord of the Rings Gollum, and it'll follow his journey through a new story that parallels Frodo's quest to destroying the One Ring. You'll pick and choose which personality you play, the shy and benign Sméagol or the malevolent Sméagol. Depending on which personality becomes more dominant as you play, Gollum's character will change visually or different dialogue options may appear and more. The game is being described as a non-combat stealth game focused mostly on the choices you make as you progress. This makes sense given Daedalic's history as a point-and-click adventure game developer. However, it sounds like Gollum will be a more traditional adventure game. And that wraps it up for today's episode of This Week in Gaming. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Let me know what story you thought was the most interesting in the comments down below, and I'll see you next time. This is Level Cap, signing off.